Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Wednesday, SpaceX successfully launched their 40th mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 651. The booster which launched this mission, B1077, then landed successfully for the 12th time on the drone ship, just read the instructions. The following day, on Thursday, SpaceX also successfully launched their 41st mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 652.
One, engines full power, and liftoff. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1080, then landed successfully for the 7th time on the drone ship, a shortfall of gravitas. This coming week, we can hopefully expect to see a bunch of missions launch. The first of these, the Starlink 653 mission, is currently scheduled for tomorrow, Monday 22nd at 10:40 PM UTC or 6:40 PM EST. A couple of days later and we can hopefully expect to see a customer mission launch. The Worldview Legion 1 and 2 mission is currently scheduled for Wednesday 24th at 6:30 PM UTC or 2:30 PM EST. A couple of days later and we can hopefully expect to see another Starlink launch. The Starlink 654 mission is currently scheduled for Friday 26th at 10:40 PM UTC or 6:40 PM EST. Then finally, later in the week, we can hopefully expect to see another customer mission launch. The Galileo L12 mission is currently scheduled for Saturday 28th at 7 AM UTC or 3 AM EST. There was an article about a partnership between SpaceX and Northrop Grumman. It says Northrop Grumman is working with SpaceX on a classified spy satellite project, already capturing high-resolution imagery of the Earth, according to people familiar with the program. Heading to Boca Chica, a crane was hooked up to a GSE tank show at the Orbital tank farm. Crews were seen working to cut the GSE shell in half for disassembly. The GSE tank shell was also lifted off of the tank as they looked to gradually scrap the old orbital tank farm. Concrete for the wall at the launch site was seen being poured into the forms. The chopsticks were seen being moved around for some testing. Work continues on the expansion of the Star Factory production building. There was an article posted about SpaceX planning to spend some millions to build some facilities at Starbase. It says the company plans to build an over $13 million recreation center and a nearly $500,000 sushi restaurant. The Texas Department of Licensing and Regulations filings showed that the projects will take full form in over a year of construction. In response to an interview with Tom Mueller where he talks about the development of the Raptor engine, Musk posted info on future versions of Raptor. It says, as it turns out, future versions of Raptor will ultimately exceed 700,000 pound force. Honing thrust to weight, ISP and reliability are much harder than thrust though. Rocket engines desperately want to explode. There was an article posted about Artemis 3 and possible changes to the mission objectives. It says, although NASA is unlikely to speak about it publicly anytime soon, the space agency is privately considering modifications to its Artemis plan to land astronauts on the surface of the moon later this decade. Multiple sources have confirmed that NASA is studying alternatives to the planned Artemis 3 landing of two astronauts on the moon, nominally scheduled for September 2026 due to concerns about hardware readiness and mission complexity. Under one of these options, astronauts would launch into low Earth orbit inside an Orion spacecraft, rendezvous there with a Starship vehicle separately launched by SpaceX. During this mission, similar to Apollo 9, a precursor to the Apollo 11 lunar landing, the crew would validate the ability of Orion and Starship to dock and test habitability inside Starship. The crew would then return to Earth. In another option NASA is considering, a crew would launch in Orion and fly to a small space station near the moon, the Lunar Gateway, and then return to Earth. It's crazy that yesterday was SpaceX's 1-year anniversary of launching Starship. They said 1 year since first flight test of Starship. Each successive launch has gone farther, and with more flights coming soon, we are rapidly building towards a fully reusable future. Work continues on Starship 29's heat shield tiles in the high bay. Here's a look at Starship 30 being worked on in Mega Bay 2. As always, I have to say thanks to both Sean Doherty and Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Gal, for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.